Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all Dinarians on the go and in the know, wherever you may be. The new CEP, Currency Exchange Planner, is a must-have for both pre- and post-RV exchange planning. The link is in the description panel below. Tell them that the Dinarian sent you so you get the extra pre-negotiated discount as my subscriber. Today is November 13th, 2019. Know that today, we are one day closer to our goal than yesterday, and we all cross the finish line together. Looks like things are actually beginning to happen in Iraq, finally. First article of interest. Liberation protesters announce a million steadfastness Friday. 2019 to 13th November 1120 Baghdad. The protesters of Tahrir Square in Baghdad on Wednesday issued a statement with the number 2. The text of the statement read, "O people of the Iraqi people, we have repeatedly stressed our first demand to dismiss the government of snipers, in support of our martyr brothers, and the dignity of their families. And here is the government, through its repressive measures used against demonstrators in the past days, near the bridge in Al Snak Bridge, dozens of martyrs and hundreds of wounded have been killed in the attack, which insists that it insists on the option of violence and criminality in suppressing protesters and silencing the voice of the people. Trustworthy, just as they are unable to stop the intimidation and systematic abduction of activists by unknown parties, despite international appeals and calls from the authorities to stop the arrests and attacks against demonstrators." In addition, the UNMIS statement's proposals proved far removed from the daily bloodshed and demonstrations and sit-ins throughout the rising provinces, as well as from the basic demands of protesters. While the authorities and those behind them are committing the most heinous crimes against unarmed youths, the UN mission proposes to the government to stop the killing machine against the demonstrators, and reform laws are presented to the House of Representatives. The UN mission may not know that the adherence of the corrupt to the government of Adel Abdul Mahdi is a compelling evidence of their reassurance and conviction that he is unable or unwilling to carry out real radical reforms, holding public theft money, and bringing the killers to justice. Demonstrating that he is subject to political blocks and adheres to party quotas. Iraqi sisters. Iraqi brothers. The demonstrations that you supported, and the demands that you have raised, have reached the voice of the entire world, and occupy international and regional decision-making centers, and we promise that they will not end with unsecured promises, and formal reform measures, do not live up to the blood given by the martyrs as an offering to this country. On behalf of Iraq, therefore, we call on you, in fulfillment of the blood of the youth, to hold millions of demonstrations next Friday, 15th November, in order to reject the solutions put forward by the government, and to affirm the demands made by the demonstrators for all these sacrifices, which showed the supreme religious authority in Najaf. Seriousness of the concerned parties in their implementation. As we declared in our first statement, there is no return to normal life except the return of the homeland that the martyrs wanted. Therefore, let our demonstrations be a million Iraqis in the name of #SUMMAH_SUMOOD. Hear all who do not want to hear the voice of the people, until our victory triumphs. Next article of interest. The Kurdish blocs refuse to amend Article 140 and exploit the current situation. 2019 to 13 November 1143. The Kurdish blocs announced its refusal. To amend any paragraph of Article 140. A deputy for the Patriotic Union of Kurdistan, PUK, Hussein Narmo, said in a press statement that Article 140 is constitutional and its implementation is better than amending it, noting that some chauvinist parties are trying from here and there to amend Article 140 and exploit the current situation in Iraq. He added that the Kurdish blocs categorically reject the amendment or change of Article 140, and even if any amendment is passed to vote within the House of Representatives, the provinces of the region will reject those amendments. He continued Nermo that the Kurdish blocs and all the people of the Kurdistan people refuse to amend or abolish Article 140 because it is very important for the people of Kurdistan. It concerns the future of the areas cut off. The 2005 Constitution defined Article 140 as a solution to the problem of Kirkuk and the so-called disputed areas between the Kurdistan region and neighboring provinces, Nineveh, Diyala and Salah al-Din. The article provides for a three-stage mechanism. First, normalization, which means addressing the changes in the demographics of Kirkuk and the disputed areas during and under Saddam's regime, and the second census in those areas, the latest referendum to determine what their residents want, before December 31. The 1st, 2007. Next article of interest. ASAB opposes passing the amendment of the local elections law. It contradicts the demands of the demonstrators. 13th November, 2019. MP Leila Habubi Block, Sadikin, parliamentary group representing the ASAB al-Haq group led by Keika Zali on Wednesday on the pursuit of some political blocks in the amendment of the election law provincial councils, despite the demands of demonstrators calling for its abolition. Habubi said in a press statement today, the House of Representatives voted during the last period to freeze the work of the provincial councils in line with the demands of the demonstrators, which called for its abolition. She added, the House of Representatives will stand in the face of anyone trying to pass laws that are contrary to the demands of the Iraqi citizen. Iraq's cabinet decided on Tuesday to postpone provincial elections until later. Next article of interest. UN ready to engage with all Iraqis to meet demands of anti-govt protests. Envoy. Source: January 2019 to 11-14, 2 hours 49 minutes and 42 seconds. Editor: Muzukwin. Baghdad, November 13th. January. The UN Assistance Mission for Iraq, UNAMI, said on Wednesday that it will continue to engage with all Iraqi parties to meet the demands of the ongoing anti-government protests over worsening living conditions in the country. Over the past 6 weeks, hundreds of thousands of peaceful Iraqis have been protesting, making genuine, legitimate demands, loud and clear, said Jeanine Hennis-Plasschaert, special representative of the UN Secretary General for Iraq, in her address to the Iraqi parliament. These demands cover a wide spectrum of issues, an end to corruption, economic growth, employment, reliable public services, prudent and impartial governance, credible elections, as well as a broader reform of the political system including amendments to the constitution, added Hennis-Plasschaert, head of the UNAMI. Since the beginning of the protests, UNAMI has actively reached out to a wide range of Iraqi parties, actors and authorities, including the President, Prime Minister and the Parliament Speaker, in addition to the Supreme Judicial Council, peaceful protesters, Parliament members and union representatives. Based on these discussions and with full respect for Iraq's sovereignty, we have proposed a number of concrete steps as a start, as a way forward to confidence building and reform, she noted. Since the start of the protests in early October, at least 319 people have been killed and around 15,000 from peaceful protesters and the security forces injured, according to Hennis-Plasschaert. The United Nations is ready to engage or continues to engage with all parties to facilitate constructive dialogue. We will continue to be a partner for all Iraqis, the UN envoy concluded. Mass demonstrations have continued in the capital Baghdad and other cities in central and southern Iraq since early October, demanding comprehensive reform, accountability for corruption, improvement of public services and job opportunities. Next article of interest. Parliament plans to replace 14 ministers and replace Abdelmahdi. 13 November 2019 call Comspress/Baghdad. A parliamentary source said on Wednesday that the House of Representatives intends to change the 14 ministers currently Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi government. The source told Kilcom's press that the House of Representatives will replace almost completely the current ministers with other ministers of technocrats, and then go to change Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi. The source said, the lack of a meeting of the House of Representatives scheduled today because of the number of quorum is complete, pointing out that the House of Representatives is going towards the semi-comprehensive change of ministers. Next article of interest. Halbousi, we will introduce three laws to vote in tomorrow's session. 13th November 2019 Kilkamish Press/Baghdad, Parliament Speaker Mohammed Al-Halbousi announced Wednesday that Parliament will submit three laws to vote in tomorrow's session. The correspondent of Kilkamish Press, that Halbousi announced that tomorrow's session will include a vote on three laws, namely, a proposal to abolish the financial privileges of officials in the Iraqi state, and the law of graft, and vote on the amendment of the Commission on Integrity. The Speaker of the Parliament Mohammed Halbousi announced in today's meeting the date of questioning two ministers in the government of Mahdi, namely, Minister of Industry and Minister of Agriculture. He explained that the date of questioning the Minister of Industry will be on Saturday, November 23, 2019, while the date of questioning the Minister of Agriculture will be on Thursday, November 28, 2019. The House of Representatives held its regular session in the presence of 229 deputies. Next article of interest. The House of Representatives intends to amend the statutes of the Commission and the elections, decisions consistent with the demands of the demonstrators. November 13, 2019 Baghdad/Obelisk. The House of Representatives during a meeting with the representative of the Secretary General of the United Nations in Iraq, Jeanine Hennis-Plasschaert, on the existence of a parliamentary agreement to implement reforms in legislation and make constitutional and ministerial amendments. The Information Office of the Deputy Speaker of the House of Representatives Hassan Al-Kabi, in a statement received to the Obelisk, the House of Representatives continues to speed up the completion of a package of legislation and reform decisions that correspond to the demands of the true demonstrators, pointing out that there is insistence at the Presidency and members of the House of Representatives the amendments to the package of important and long-awaited laws by the people over the past years, including the Elections and Elections Commission and the necessary constitutional and ministerial amendments, stressing that the reform package will include voting on service legislation that meets the needs of society. He stressed the need to maintain partnership with the United Nations in all that serves Iraq and cooperation in the development of laws to meet the aspirations of all spectrums of the Iraqi people. Next article of interest. Halbousi confirms to proceed with the enactment of several laws, including Where Do You Get This? 2019 to 13th November 1720 Baghdad. The Speaker of the House of Representatives, Mohammed Halbousi, during the Parliament session for this Wednesday to proceed with the legislation of laws that serve the social reality. Halbousi said during the session that the Parliament continues to legislate laws that serve the social and health reality, which contribute to the solution of the accumulated problem experienced by the country, especially laws, Where You This, the federal court, investment, health insurance, the law of the Council of Ministers and Ministers, declaring that the Council has completed the second reading and discussed it, calling on the competent committees to mature the laws to be submitted to the vote in the next sessions during the current month. More articles of interest to come. Hit that like and the subscribe button and check out the new CEP, Currency Exchange Planner, a must-have for both pre- and post-RV exchange planning. The link is in the description panel below. Be sure to tell them that the Dinarian sent you so you get the extra pre-negotiated discount as my subscriber. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.